Corey Woods, even known as Raekwon the Chef, is notorious for being one of the original members in the Wu-Tang Clan, as well as having a successful solo career due to his way of painting true-to-life pictures with his clever way of rhyming. This video will take a look back at Raekwon's humble beginnings, as well as taking a look at the height of his career. This is the Raekwon story. Hydro slide more like when I go fly ride those sh- looking wide open glide yo flipping the page I go watch 5-0 jump on my meat ride slow watch those undercovers cop those rock those glock close leaving back and collect spot grows keep a watch froze lean on the yacht watch close let the chop blow back and have a block pot close. Raekwon was born in Brooklyn in 1970, and at the early age of 10, he and his mother moved to Park Hill, Staten Island. And according to Raekwon, Park Hill was one of the most hated projects in Staten Island. It was drugs, money, guns, and prostitution, and it forced him to grow up fast. And sooner than later, Raekwon started rolling with this one and that one, pulling out gats for fun. Nonetheless, coming from Staten Island or the Shaolin land, Raekwon and RZA always knew about each other, even going to the same school at one point. However, they never got too close to each other until much later, until the creation of the Wu-Tang Clan. RZA had already tried his luck in the music business as a solo artist under the name Prince Rakim. Having said that, he wasn't met with great success, and he knew he had to go about it in a different way. And the way was to create a group that no one could ever have imagined. And to set up the group, RZA decided to recruit the best rappers he knew. The Jizza, Older the Bastard, Inspector Deck, Raekwon the Chef, You God, Ghostface Killah, and the Method Man.
You come to the studio, So me not knowing who gonna be there, I just show up. So I see who I see. Like, okay, yeah, I know you get down, I know. Yeah, yo, Ghost here, yeah, we ain't really from the same town and all that, but you know what I mean? Get one of them, get your hand off me real quick shit. So next thing you know, RZA's like, yo, this is what I wanna do. You know what I'm saying? This is the song. This is what we gonna do. We gonna make a record and we gonna represent Shaolin together.
In October of 1992, they recorded their first single, Protect Your Neck, which was followed by their first album, Enter the Wu-Tang 36 Chamber, where Raekwon got the first verse on the track C.R.E.A.M, which is without a doubt the clan's most successful song ever. I grew up on the crime side, the New York Times side, staying alive was no job, had second hands, moms bounced on old men. So then we moved to Shaolin land, a young youth, you're rocking the gold tooth, low goose, only way I begin to G-York was drug loot, and let's start it like this son, rolling with this one and that one, pulling out gats for fun. After the release of the first album, Raekwon got signed to Loud Records as a solo artist, where he released his debut single Heaven and Hell for the soundtrack of the movie Fresh. And following the single, Raekwon released his first album, named Only Built for Cuban Links, which was of course produced by the RZA. Nonetheless, the album was a success, and it peaked at number 4 on the Billboard 200. And due to tracks like Ice Cream and Glass Years of Ice, it received gold status. To put it briefly, the album aimed at a crowd who could relate to the culture on the street. Therefore, it was only built for the people who could understand the language of the ghetto, which explains the name, Only Built for Cuban Links. On the album, Raekwon rhymed like a true mafioso, where he told the story like a movie, revolving around criminal activity, cocaine trafficking, and the gangster lifestyle. Upon its release, the album was nicknamed the Purple Tape, due to the original cassette being tinted in purple. The reason behind this was because Raekwon wanted his album to stand out, just like drug dealers tag their own product. And not to mention, the album also introduced us to the dynamic duo between Raekwon and Ghostface Killah, which is one of the most iconic partnerships in the history of hip-hop. What up, boo? Peace, your highness, yo, I'm lounging. Big style, y'all niggas is the flyers. Moves you're making, true five choosers, shaking out a rape patient. You're looking good, fly colored Asian. Ghettos, them is your hometown. We could go the whole round. After that, I'm shooting downtown. shortly thereafter, the collaboration continued between the two on Ghostface album, which is also considered to be a classic. Following that, Raekwon continued his solo career, releasing the albums Immobility and The Lex Diamond Story. However, the two albums were met with mixed reviews, and Raekwon later voiced the albums had a lack of promotion and budget. Despite that, the next album, only built for Cuba Links Part 2, wouldn't be a disappointment. It was released in 2009, with producers working on it like J Dilla, Pete Rock, Dr. Dre, The Alchemist, Eric Sermon, Scram Jones, and of course, The RZA. Upon its release, the album entered at number 4 on the Billboard 200, and it was met with great reviews, receiving the Album of the Year award from Hip Hop DX. Following the success of the album, Raekwon decided to team up with Method Man and Ghostface Killah for the album Wu Massacre. Since then, Raekwon has continued to build his discography, with the albums Shaolin vs. Wu-Tang, Fila, The Wild, and right now there is talks about Only Built for Cuba Links Part 3, which I think we all are excited about. Nonetheless, what Raekwon has achieved throughout his career is nothing short of amazing, playing a big part in one of the most infamous hip-hop groups ever, as well as having a successful solo career, rhyming with technical brilliance, with complete originality, using vivid metaphors to tell stories like a true mafioso.
Now the Joe Button shit, I seen when y'all snuffed him. That was hard.
It was kidnapping like a motherfucker.
I seen the tape.
Nah, they just hung out the roof for a little bit.
Listen. He was talking wild shit.
But you know,
Then you seen him.
Yeah.
And then y'all spoke, and then he went and talked wild shit again, and then him and Mickey Fat said some shit, and then y'all seen them. What happened right now?
Yeah, I mean, it was just getting taken too far out of hand, and I tried to neutralize it.
You know what's my favorite part of the video?
I tried to neutralize it.
When you put his hat back on, he was like, yeah, young man. Yo, I said this nigga Raekwon is a mobster. Yo, you snuff a nigga and put his hat back on? Oh my God. Yo, you a different type of nigga. Yo, you can't front on
my
me,
nigga,
man.
Listen,
I see the tape. Go ahead.
I didn't hit him.
I didn't say you hit him.
I didn't hit him.
But you put his hat back on. That's what makes it worse.
It's like you might as well.
That's what makes it worse. Because, let me tell you something. I ain't never, like, I met mobsters, like real mobsters. I met mafioso niggas, but I've never actually seen them do mafioso shit. This was the closest thing to, like, this is mafioso shit, my nigga.